हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई होप यू ऑल आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस एप्ट एंड क्विक मेथड फॉर फाइंडिंग द ट्रिपलेट्स इन ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। इफ़ यू लाइक माय वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन फॉर अपडेट्स। फर्स्टली लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ट्रिपलेट्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ पाइथागोरस थ्योरम। The Pythagoras theorem says that in a right angle triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of legs, where hypotenuse is the side which is opposite to the right angle and the other two sides are known as the legs. So by taking triangle ABC, which is right angled at C, AC square plus BC square will be equal to AB square. And in terms of sides, if AC is B, which is the side opposite to angle B, and BC is small a, which is the side opposite to angle A, and AB is small c, which is the side opposite to angle C, we will have A square plus B square is equals to C square. And the definition of Pythagorean triplets is when the side lengths of the right triangle satisfy the Pythagorean theorem, then these three numbers which are satisfying the relation are known as Pythagorean triplets or the triples. Let us learn how to generate triplets in seconds. So we have this method. Firstly, we will write down this table in which nothing is difficult. We will write down the counting in the first row. Then in the first column also we are going to write the counting. Then in the second or the third row, we are going to write the multiples or table, you can say. For 1, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then for 2, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Then for 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, like this and so on, we will continue our table. And suppose we want to find out the triplets now. What you have to do, firstly, you will see the diagonal, which I have marked in red. And these are actually the square numbers. Now choose any two numbers. Suppose we choose 1 and 9, which I have encircled, and add those numbers, you will get 10. Subtracting these numbers, we will get 8. Now you have to choose all those elements across the diagonal which are having same row and column as those of the numbers which we selected. As we selected 1 and 9, so across the row of and column of 9, we will get 3 when we are moving towards right, and when we are moving downwards, we will again get 3. So add these two numbers and you will get 3 plus 3 as 6. So now the numbers 6, 8 and 10 will form the triplets. Let us learn how to check whether the numbers are forming the Pythagorean triplet or not. Let us have question 7, 24, 25. Taking A as 7, B as 24, C as 25. Using the identity or the formula C square is equals to A square plus B square, which came by the statement of Pythagoras theorem. C square is equals to 25 square, which is equals to 625. And A square plus B square, when we calculate, we will get 7 square plus 24 square, which is equals to 625 again. So left hand side is equals to right hand side, and hence the numbers 7, 24 and 25 are forming the Pythagorean triplet. Let us learn one more method for finding the triplets. For any natural number m, numbers 2m, m square minus 1, m square plus 1 form a Pythagorean triplet. Now let us take one question. Write a Pythagorean triplet whose one member is given to you as 18. So since 18 is an even number, so we can take 2m as 18, which is one of the members of the triplet. So m we will get as 9. Now calculating the values of m square minus 1 and m square plus 1, we will get 80 and 82. And hence the Pythagorean triplet will be 18, 80 and 82. Next important thing is how to create or how to learn the triplets. from one triplet you can create many triplets. Suppose we have 3, 4, 5, which is representing the ratios of the side lengths that satisfy the Pythagorean theorem, or we have one triplet as 3, 4, 5, then we can create other triplets by multiplying any of these triplets by a number. Let us take example of 3, 4, 5, then multiplying it by 2, we will get 8, 6, 10, and that is also a Pythagorean triplet. Similarly, if 5, 12, and 13 is one of the triplets, multiplying by 2, we will get 10, 24, and 26, which is also a Pythagorean triplet. By this way, you can find as many triplets as you want. I hope you all like the video. Thank you so much for watching the video.